So how did an inmate in Vermont get police officers to put an image of a pig on their cruisers? Here's CNN's Jeanne Moos.
Forget pigs in a pen. This is about a pig that came out of the pen, as in penitentiary, and ended up on Vermont State Police cruisers. The cruisers are decked out with decals based on Vermont's coat of arms. But at a correctional facility print shop where female inmates make the decals, someone changed the spots on the cow. The pig ended up on as many as 30 police cruisers, and you know from the movies what pig means to police.
Bacon, pig, oink, oink, police officer.
You're going to jail, you f***ing pig.
In this case, the perpetrator was already in jail. It's believed an inmate doctored the image at the printing shop 4 years ago, though the pig wasn't noticed until an officer saw it on a cruiser just last week. Next thing you know, people start spotting pigs in places other than the cow's spots. They're seeing a pig's head formed by the cow's shadow. It may be a stretch, but do you see two ears and a snout? Vermont State Senator John Campbell laughed off the incident.
It's just like, where's Waldo? We're going to say, where's the pig?
But Vermont's Corrections Commissioner Andy Polito wasn't so jolly about the police being slipped a pig.
And I apologize to them.
A spokesperson for the state police says they understand the humor in this, but the prank does come at a cost to taxpayers. New decals will run about $800. But using the term pig isn't what it used to be.
I smell bacon. Does anyone else smell bacon?
Yeah, I definitely smell a pork product of some type.
Nowadays, police themselves call their own sporting events the Pig Bowl. And while everyone was looking for more pigs, some wanted to know what the weird yellow mushroom phallic things are. Get your mind out of the gutter. They're bundles of grain. Stop being a pig. Jeanne Moos, CNN, New York.